He donned the jersey back in 1996, and he quickly became the face of the organization for 17 years. Jerome Iginla was a leader both on and off the ice. He was a goal scorer, but also not afraid to drop the gloves. I caught up with Pat Steinberg from Sportsnet Fan 960 to talk about Iginla's impact. Well, Pat, it is easy to see why Jerome Iginla was such a fan favorite. He had great intensity and skills on the ice and great charm off the ice, a really big smile and things like that. But take us back maybe 20 years, and what did Iginla actually mean to this Flames franchise and to hockey in the city?
Well, I mean, for the longest time, he was the guy in this city. And it's crazy because when he was acquired, I don't know if people thought that was going to be the case. So he was brought in a huge trade for Joe Nieuwendyk in 1995. And Joe Nieuwendyk at the time was the guy for the Flames. And he'd won a Stanley Cup. He'd scored 50 goals. And so Joe Nieuwendyk didn't want to be in Calgary anymore. So he got traded to Dallas. And they brought in this guy who played in Kamloops of the Western Hockey League. And not a lot of people knew who Jerome Iginla was. So he comes in and immediately makes an impact in a playoff series. And a couple years later, out of nowhere, scores 50 goals. And then the legend started to grow. And then he started to become the guy. And as time went along, he got invited to the Olympics in 2002 and made a huge impact in Canada, snapping a 50-year drought and winning gold. So, and then obviously what happened in 2004, which was, you know, the most surprising and unexpected thing that Flames fans had seen in 20 years. So he really did mean everything to this team. He was the face of the franchise. He was the best player on the team. He led the team in scoring for 11 straight years. And more importantly, he was the guy that whenever you associated the Flames outside of this market, people thought about Jerome Iginla because he was one of the two or three best players in the world anywhere for a good 4 or 5 year span.
All right, such a career over 2 decades. Tell us, do you have one classic Iggy highlight that you think of when the name is mentioned?
I'll give you two. One's in a Flames uniform and one is in a Team Canada uniform. So the first one is obviously the golden goal in 2010. And go look back at that goal because, yes, Sidney Crosby scores it and he'll always be the one that gets the accolades for it. But go take a look at what Jerome is doing while he's making that pass. He's got Ryan Suter all over him. He's getting his face slammed into the boards, and he still finds a way to make a backhand pass to Crosby. And, like, you go and you feel for Ryan Miller, the American goalie at the time, because you're like, well, of course he didn't see it coming, because how did the puck get on Crosby's stick? So it was an incredible assist, and so that one obviously sticks out. But I have to say, and the reason why it sticks out so much for me is because I got to be here for it, was when he scored his 500th goal. And it was so cool because he scored his 500th goal in, like, the least Jerome Iginla way ever. It was a weird pass to the front of the net that deflected off a skate and in. Like, all of his goals are scored from the right wing, just wiring a shot past a goalie. This one was the ugliest goal he might have ever scored. But the broadcaster at the time, the Hall of Fame voice of the Calgary Flames, Peter Marr, saw it, and he called it as if it was the greatest goal he ever scored. I was sitting 2 seats from Peter Marr doing the broadcast, and so to have the best player ever for the Calgary Flames and this guy that I looked up to and Peter Marr call it so perfectly, that to me is my favorite moment in a Flames uniform for Jerome.
What a cool experience to be a part of, and I'm sure we could go on for hours about Jerome Iginla highlights, but we know what he's done on the ice. Can you tell us a little bit more about maybe the guy he was off the ice and what he meant, his leadership, his love of sport, and the love of this city?
Well, I think first of all, when you talk about Jerome, you always have to think about the smile and the way that he treated everybody. Like, there was never, at least to us in the media, it didn't matter what the circumstance. They could have won 5-1, they could have lost 9-0. It didn't seem to matter. He would always be there. He'd answer your questions. He'd clearly listen. He'd smile, and he treated you and clearly showed a genuine respect for you. So that's the number one thing. But you hear about Jerome kind of behind closed doors. You talk to Craig Conroy or Martin Gélinas or the people that played with him, and the thing about him is the competitive streak. Like, he was a lead by example type guy, and what he did for that team as the captain for so many years was lead by example because he played with that competitive streak and that intensity. And so he just almost felt like, geez, this guy is number one in fitness testing. This guy leaves it all on the ice every single shift. You kind of have to go follow him. So those would be a couple of things. And just from my standpoint, was always just so gracious with his time. You know, I remember years when the final media availability of the year, he'd do a 25-minute scrum, and I'd have one question for him near the end, and he'd answer it like it was the first. And he was just always a really gracious, genuine, and respectful person, which is what you want in a captain and what you want as a face of the organization. But you don't always get that, but with Jerome, you did.
Iginla's number 12 jersey will be retired to the rafters before the Flames game against Minnesota tomorrow night. So tune in tomorrow at 11 for City News, where we're going to have a very big special devoted to Iginla's special night.